So if you went for a Valve Index or any other VR headset coming from an HTC Vive, then you probably have some HTC Vive controllers lying around somewhere, not using it anymore, like us. So why not use it for something else? You can actually very easily transform these into Vive trackers, which are these, so that you can use it as body trackers, as feet trackers or waist trackers, whatever you would like. Well, at least in games that support it, like in this game. But how do you do this? This is where this video comes in handy. This is going to be a guide for transforming your HTC Vive controllers into Vive trackers. This is coming up. Subscribe if you haven't yet to see more VR videos like this one. Okay, so what do you need? You will need four things. First, a Steam VR tracking in place. Second, your Vive controllers. Third, a Steam controller dongle per controller. You can get a Steam Controller Dongle for $13. I will link it below. And then lastly, Velcro or something else to attach the controllers to your body. Now let's get started with the guide. I will put the timestamps per step below in the description. In this guide, I will assume that you already have Steam VR tracking in place, which you probably already have if you have the Vive controllers. So in the first couple of steps, we will convert the Vive controllers to act like Vive trackers. So in step one, we will turn off Steam VR. Now disconnect your headset and other Steam VR devices you might have connected, and then launch Steam VR again. Turn on the controller you want to convert and plug it in your computer with a USB cable. We now need access to the controller's configuration, so let's move on to step two. Find the Lighthouse Console.x application. It is located in your Steam install folder. So mine is here in my PC, program files, Steam, Steam apps, common, Steam VR, tools, Lighthouse, bin, Win64. Yes, we're finally here. Now open the Lighthouse Console.x application by double clicking it. If you see this, then it's correct. It has opened a VR controller. Now here, type in download config. This will create a file in the same folder, which is the configuration for your controller. We need to edit this file and change a couple of values. But before we do that, let's make a copy and backup the original settings. I'm just going to do that by right-clicking it, pressing copy, then paste. I'll automatically make a copy, which you can rename by appending .backup or something, or just leave it as a copy. In step three, we are editing the configuration. You can open it with Notepad or Notepad++. So let's right-click it. I'm using Notepad++. And then you can use the finder to find the device class, or usually it is already on like line 12 here, as you can see. And then we have to change this value controller to generic tracker. Make sure you do the underscore, and also a quick note here, make sure the device class was controller and not something else like HMD. Because if it isn't a controller, you should not change this file and recheck if you unplugged everything first and probably redo step one first. You should have no VR headset cables in your computer at all. Now use the finder by going to search find, or using Ctrl+F and search for model number. And here you have to change these three lines to this. I have it copied already. I will paste this down below in the description as well, so that you can just easily copy paste it. Just make sure you got everything, including this comma at the end. Now you can just save the file by using Ctrl+S or using save here. You can close it. We now need to upload this new configuration back to the controller. So in step four, go back to the Lighthouse console window, which we haven't closed yet, and type in upload config, add a space. And now we need to add the name of the config that we just edited. So I'm just moving it here. And in my case, it's LHR stripe FF and then 68B940.json. Press enter and it will upload that config back to the controller. And now you can just type in power off and then exit to exit this application. Now also unplug the controller and make sure to power it off too. You can repeat step 1 to 4 for every controller that you may have. I have two HTC VIVE controllers, so I did this twice. Now, if you have already updated your Steam Controller Dongles or have a different Steam VR USB dongle, then you can use them with the HTC VIVE controllers that you just configured. They will show up as HTC VIVE Trackers in the Steam VR window now. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I will explain how to update your Steam Controller Dongles in the next steps. While you're watching this video, do please leave a like if you found this video helpful so far. So, let's move on. In the next steps, we will update the firmware on the Steam Controller Dongles. Because straight out of the box, the Steam Controller Dongles do not detect the Vive controllers. So we need to convert them to what Valve calls the Watchman Dongles. If you have a Steam Controller dongle lying around and don't use it for anything else, then great, you can just use that. Just please be aware that you currently cannot convert them back to normal Steam Controller dongles, so if you need the dongles for something else, don't convert them, buy new ones instead for this purpose. So, time for step 5. We will be needing the latest Watchman update. To get them, you need to install the Steam VR Tracking HDK. To be able to, you need to apply as a developer on Steam. Now go to partnersteamgames.com, which I've already done here, and log in with your Steam account, which I've also already done here. Now, click on sign up for the Steam VR tracking licensee, and then read and fill in all the information that they need. I'm going to do that and skip through this. And if you reach this page that says you're now a Steamworks partner, you're ready. Now the Steam VR Tracking HDK will automatically show up in your account on Steam under Library, Software. As you can see here, Steam VR Tracking HDK. Now install the app. So once installed, we can move on to step 6. Open the HDK's local files folder by right-clicking the Steam VR Tracking HDK in Steam, then go to Properties, Local Files, Browse Local Files. This will automatically open the install folder. Step 7. It's time for the update, so grab a Steam Controller dongle that you want to update and plug it in your PC. Open a command prompt in the Steam VR Tracking SDK install folder. By clicking on this bar over here, you can delete this path and then type in cmd here. Press enter. This will neatly open a command prompt in just the right folder that we need. Now, to update the Steam Controller dongle, we have to type in this command. Tools bin install. I will also copy and paste this command down below in the description to make it easier. But you can also type it out yourself. Once you're done, press enter. Ah, I need to exit Steam first, so let's do that first. All right, let's do this command again. Also, make sure that you use a capital D and did not mistype anything. Once you press enter, it will start updating. If you see something like successfully converted firmware, then it worked. Right now you're seeing this here. It's skipping because I already updated my Steam Controller dongles. I already did these updates with the Steam Controller dongles in a different tutorial before. That's why I'm seeing this, but I will show you the screen that you should see now. So you can repeat step 4 to 6 for every Steam Controller dongle that you have. Just make sure to plug in only one so that it doesn't confuse which one to update. Now in step 8, we can start Steam VR again. So let's start it right now. Here, make sure you have the right Steam Controller dongles plugged in already and start Steam VR. Oh yeah, don't forget to plug in your headset and everything else again. So I'm just going to do that. So I just plugged in my headset again. Now I'm going to start Steam VR again. You can now pair the HTC VIVE controllers by right-clicking the Steam VR
window, then going to devices, then pair controller. Now, you want to click to, I want to pair a different type of controller, because you want a HTC VIVE Tracker now, so not the VIVE controllers, but you want this one. Now, it will ask you to press and hold the system button, so one button only, but on the VIVE controllers, you have to press the menu and system buttons at the same time until you see the blue blinking light. It will now be paired as a VIVE Tracker instead of a HTC VIVE controller, as you can see here. The icon for the VIVE Tracker has appeared on the Steam VR window. You can close this by pressing done or pair another HTC VIVE controller. And now you can even right click this, go to manage VIVE trackers, and you can identify each tracker to see if it will vibrate. If it vibrates, then it's done. So you can do this for both HTC VIVE controllers, and you can start playing any game with body and feet tracking. Using the original VIVE trackers is definitely still better, since they are lighter and they come with straps. But hey, if you have the HTC VIVE controllers laying around, why not use it for something else and getting a bit creative on how to mount it on your body. Like here, I'm using some kind of random Velcro attachment to mount the VIVE controllers on me, but I'm thinking of 3D printing something out to attach it on me instead. Also, here are some quick notes. If you have the Valve Index base stations, then the original HTC VIVE controllers do not work with them. Only HTC VIVE Pro controllers will work with them. I made it work with the original HTC VIVE controllers because I'm using the original HTC VIVE base stations. So, if you run the same setup, then you can do it too. If you have the HTC VIVE Pro controllers and the new Index base stations, then you could probably do this guide as well, but I have no way of testing that for you. And if you want to go back to controllers, you can just follow steps 1 to 4 again, but instead of uploading the new configuration, upload the original configuration file that you backed up in step 2. So that was it. I hope you enjoyed this video, and let us know down below if you are going to try this out and in what games you are going to try some body tracking with. We would love to know. And a special thanks goes to Art Armin, our right hand patron, and a special shout out goes to his Patreon page. Everyone, thank you so much for watching once again, and see you in the next video. As always, VR on! So if you went for a Valve Index or any other headset, feet or body trackers, but so that you, no, forgot.